Hi, I'm Shannon, and I'm going to show you how to watch your live streaming class using ETSU eLearning Cisco Webex. First, we're going to go to our D2L page, that's elearn.etsu.edu, and at the top of that page, we're going to find the Select a Course pull down. My page probably looks a little bit different than the student page, it's because I'm staff. We're going to go to the pull down. Now, it has to be a ETSU streaming class pull down in order for these instructions to work. You'll see your class information. It'll look a little different from mine, and you're going to find two boxes: Summer 2014 Streaming and Video Archives Summer 2014. We're not going to worry with this box. This is after the class has happened, how to go back and watch the video. What we are going to look at is Summer 2014 Streaming. The first thing you see here is for help with Webex streaming, and what that's going to do is provide a link to eLearning Technical Support Desk. When you click that link, it's going to take you to the eLearning Technical Support Desk, where you'll find the ability to look up your own knowledge base items. Look for Webex, and we get a how-to. Or you can just go straight to Submit a Request. Submit a Request will send your request to one of our eLearning ITV staff. Enter your email address, your subject, a complete description of the problem. Details can make a huge difference. Fill out the rest of the form, hit submit. We will reply to you in email as quickly as we can. If we go back to the top of the page, you can live chat with a tech, generally between 8 and 4:30. You'll often find a tech online, and they're able to chat with you live right there. And there's another way you'll be able to chat with a tech. I'll get to that once we launch Webex. So let's close this out. And we're going to go back to our D2L page. At the top of our box, we're going to find information on the class. The title of the class, when it meets, the time it meets, meeting number, and password. Now remember, most classes through the middle of the day are going to connect to the conference three to five minutes before class. This will give you just a couple minutes to get connected before it gets going. If you try to connect too far before the scheduled class time, then you're not going to be able to connect to your conference. And this time right here is the time that the conference comes up. So for this, if you tried to connect at 7:50, you should be able to get into the conference. We're going to go down to our instructions now to join this online meeting. We're going to go to this web link. If we're requested, we're going to enter the name and email address. If we require a password, this is it. This is actually a fake password. The passwords are class specific. So for each class you take through e-learning streaming, you're going to have to go to your D2L page for that class and get your password. And then you'll click join. Should be fairly straightforward. We're going to click on this link, and I already have one open. And that's going to take us to the Webex page. Over here again is your information on the class. And this is what you're going to need to fill out. We're going to need you to fill out your complete name, because that is how the instructors and our techs will be taking roll, so you don't want to be counted absent when you're not. And we'll need your email address. So go ahead and enter that. I'm taking a shortcut to speed things up. Next, you hit join, and you're going to have to install the Cisco Webex add-on. It shouldn't take too long. You just hit install. You're going to save it to your hard drive. I'm going to save it right on my desktop. I've done this before, can you tell? And now I'm going to launch the little program that ran on the desktop. You saw there were instructions that explained on how to go through the steps that I just did. And now it's just going to take about a minute for that to get installed, and our Webex meeting will come up. What you're going to see on the Webex meeting, it'll load the interface. Up here on the right, you're going to see a video screen, and that's live video coming from the classroom. And over here, eventually, you're going to see the content. That's the document camera or the computer. To communicate back with your instructor, you have the choice of either using the phone or your computer audio. If you choose to use a phone, you call in to the conference by entering your phone number, hit call me, the conference will call back. There's also the call-in selection where you just dial these numbers, enter the access code, and you'll automatically dial right in. So you'll be able to hear and be heard. So remember, mute those phones the moment you dial in. For our purposes, we're going to use the computer audio. We're going to use the built-in microphone. And now we're going to run a quick test of our speaker system. There it was. Yes, it sounds good. Our microphone is currently on, and as you can see, it's registering my voice. Yes, it is good. And now we're just going to hit OK, and that's going to finish up our configuration process and take us to our WebEx meeting. You'll see these little things saying you don't have a webcam. Currently, I have the webcam turned off, but the first thing you want to do is go over here and mute yourself. Otherwise, your microphone or your phone, which is left open, is going to be heard through the entire conference. We're going to have text monitoring, and the instructor will definitely notice it. But first thing you need to do, mute that audio. Now, let's go into the classroom. Right now, the teacher has nothing shared. Let's say they're going to go to the document camera. They share the document camera. It's going to take just a second, but when it pops up, you're going to see the entire screen change. There we go. And now this is the main classroom interface that you're going to see. This is what we call the content channel. Right now, it's this document camera right over here. You can see it on the right of the screen. This is where they would display textbooks or demonstration items or graphs or something that is not digital. They can also punch up the computer and display PowerPoints, web pages, YouTube, anything like that right here on this content square. It's nice and large. You can see the video at all times. If you want to see the video in greater detail, you can hit this button right here, and that's going to zoom in on the video only. Notice our content, the overhead camera, is no longer visible. However, we are muted still, so you can still control that. If you have a question, all you do is unmute and you're good to go. Now, moving on, exit out of full screen mode. We have a bar up here with a few controls. Again, you can mute yourself using that button right there. The audio controls are right here. If you need to go back, retest your microphone, set those volume levels, you do it right there. Hit this button, it'll bring you participant list. This participant list, again, will show you if you're muted or not. It'll also show the telepresence system, which is the classroom and the infrastructure that we use to deliver the video to you. And you'll see a list of all the people that are in that classroom. Instructors are not going to be able to hear you raise your hand. That's a limitation of the telepresence system, but everyone else in the room will. So we're going to close that back up. Now there's a chat box, but the chat box is kind of a special deal. The only people that are able to see the chat box are going to be the people that are also in this WebEx meeting and the techs. So if you have a question about a technical problem you're having or just a general question about the class, you can ask that and a tech will be monitoring and able to answer right here. So if it's a simple question, you don't necessarily have to fill out a trouble ticket. Maybe we'll be able to answer your question right here. If it does turn out to be something a little more involved, that tech will probably have you go and fill out that trouble ticket. So we're going to close that chat window. Here are a few more options. Return to meeting window is the same as this button right here. We'll hit that and return. Now this is, again, on our main page that we had when we first connected with no content being shared, but now that we have that content being shared, you can return to sharing to see it by hitting that button, and now you're going to see that overhead camera, that video connection, and it's a very tidy screen. Down here you may see some silhouettes of other students. They'll also have their audio muted. Let's go back to this. Now to leave the meeting, if for some reason you need to leave before the meeting expires, you go down here to leave a meeting, hit the button, leave the meeting. This has been a quick tutorial on how to use the Cisco WebEx meeting. If you have any questions, please contact the Office of eLearning or go to that trouble ticket right here available on your D2L page. We're glad to help. That's what we're here for. Thank you very much.